Okay, now welcome to the last stop on this tour bus to the top. Where I was told her work would lure us. Sure enough, look where I'm headed. The opposite direction of the life that I dreaded.
All right, folks, welcome in. Let me get the guys on. What's up, Brian?
Yeah, what's up, man? Let's do baseball. I'm going on the radio.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's old school, man. It's how a lot of baseball fans have tracked the baseball through the years. So let's get Justin on. What's up, Justin?
What's good, man?
Good to have you on, brother. And I believe Tim's there. What's up, Tim?
Game, but it's pretty uneventful.
Yeah, it is. Is your buddy AC calling in tonight?
No, he couldn't make it tonight.
Well, that's okay.
Hey, maybe you have a little bit more vigor in your voice, man. You sound like the day's been owning you. You should be owning the day, bro.
Yeah, oh, wait a minute here. There's no way you can be cheering for the American League, Tim.
Oh, I'm not, believe me.
Okay.
Please, man, cheering for the American League.
Well, who's the All-Star MVP right now? Is it Prince Fielder?
It's got to be with that big blast. Who else has been in the game long enough to make an impact bigger than a three-run home run?
Yeah, that was epic. That was epic. So, we'll get into more All-Star game talk in a minute, but I want to bring up a very controversial topic that I think we're all gonna hit from all angles. Okay. Barry Bonds. Very polarizing figure, and you guys know my stance on the Barry Bonds thing. I think he's Hall of Famer, all right? But my question is, okay, with Hank Aaron, who's obviously very accurate at the plate, you know, he was, he had a very respectable batting average, decent on-base percentage, slugging percentage was ridiculous. You know, I mean, even during the prime of his career, he was up there stealing bases and stuff like that. But all things considered, let's just say that we all know that Barry Bonds was enhanced. Okay, to say otherwise would not be fair. But who was the better player? Hank Aaron or Barry Bonds? Let's start with Justin.
I'm going to have to go with Hank Aaron.
Okay, and why? Is it the steroids? Or do you think he was just a flat-out better player?
I think he was a flat-out better player.
Oh, okay. All right. What about you, Brian?
Well, considering that, I think Hank Aaron won the Golden Gloves Award, or was on the Golden Gloves team, you know, one of the years, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I mean, he did have a respectable batting average, you know, compared to Barry Bonds. You know, I say he's better overall, but I still think even without the enhancements, Barry Bonds still, I think, has better power than he does at the plate.
Let me give you guys some numbers here. For instance, 1990. Now we're talking the Bobby Bonilla, Barry Bonds, Pittsburgh Pirates. Okay? 1990, Barry Bonds had 156 hits. Alright? Had 33 home runs, 114 RBIs, 52 stolen bases, a 301 batting average, a 406 on-base percentage, and a 565 slugging percentage. Could Hank Aaron have done that, Tim?
No way in hell. I mean, Barry Bonds is the greatest player of all time. If you take away the steroids and he just naturally put up those numbers, he would have been the greatest player of all time. He hit 73 home runs in 1 year. The only thing that this guy missed was a ring, and I think it was oftentimes because he was bad in a clubhouse, but he could field, he could steal bases. I mean, regardless, even before the steroids, this guy was a top 10 player, at least hitter of all time. And he was pretty decent with the glove. He got horrible at the end of his career, and he probably should have moved to the American League. But the bottom line is, I can't stand Barry Bonds, and I will never think he's a Hall of Famer, but had he put those numbers up naturally, probably the greatest player of all time.
Yeah, but what about the years where he was obviously natural?
Those were extremely, extremely good years, but they're still below numbers that guys like Babe Ruth put up, guys like Hank Aaron. Hank Aaron was hitting deep, well into 30 home runs later in his career. Barry Bonds wouldn't have done that naturally because he had 28 in his last season on steroids.
Hey, wait a second. Baseball players were using amphetamines back then.
Yeah.
I mean, so we can't just say that, you know, those guys, like Hank Aaron was batting during the 70s, or 60s and 70s, you know, at least his prime year. We can't just say that.
But
let me ask you guys,
I don't know that Hank Aaron used that, so you have to operate like he didn't use it, and if you find out differently, then that's a different case.
Okay. I know
Barry Bonds gives out the signs of using steroids, but so far he hasn't been caught. So, I mean, we can't say that he actually did or not.
Yeah, he has been caught, though. They have a test thing at the Balco lab, this whole huge steroid thing. They had a positive test of the guy. On the cup, it had Barry B. written on it. I can't possibly think of another Barry B. who played in the MLB. And he used it. We don't need evidence to prove anything here. This guy used it.
Wait a minute.
We have people who've said they've given it to him, that his trainer continues to go to jail for him because there's no other way. The government's going after him. He used steroids. And Hank Aaron might have used amphetamines, but I'm sorry. Amphetamines did not have the impact that steroids did. And I'm not saying that that's okay, but it didn't make...
Let me ask you guys this. Barry Bonds was on roids from the age of 35, you know, until whenever he stopped. All right?
And that was his prime.
No, his prime were the years where he was stealing 37, 40, 30, you know, 30, 40 bases, 50 bases.
How can it be a crime when you're batting 350, hitting 70 home runs, and driving in 145 RBI?
Well, that was actually 370.
Yeah, like, how can that not be a crime?
Because he was more of a five-tool baseball player back.
But there's a limit, though. Like, when you go from hitting 40 to 70 home runs, doesn't that kind of cancel out? I mean, he was still a decent runner at the early part of his steroids, and he was still a respectable fielder. When you hit 73 home runs, I can't say it's not your prime.
Well, that was his prime as a slugger, but as a baseball player. I mean, okay, well, let me ask you this, Tim. How did steroids help his patients at the plate?
How did they do what?
How did steroids help his patients at the plate?
Well, he saw less pitches because of the steroids.
Well, I mean, a lot of guys like Sammy Sosa would swing out of his shoes at a lot of the pitches.
Barry Bonds was a smart player. I think we all know that. He still works with hitters now. He'd probably be a great hitting coach. I don't want to ever see him in the game, but I think it's a joke that Mark McGuire's allowed in the game, and he shouldn't be allowed in the game. That's ridiculous to me, especially when he's admitted he's used steroids. But to the Bonds point, I don't know. This argument to me, it's kind of like I want to put this behind everything.
Well, why is it, though? Because, I mean, you still have to give credit. I mean, you know, I mean, everybody's going to do dirt at some point. And think of it this way, had that not happened, where would baseball be right now? I mean, baseball would still be in a dead era had that not happened.
No, they wouldn't. Would have brought baseball back.
Look, Albert Pujols. Albert Pujols was, but Albert Pujols and Ryan Howard, those guys were watching Mark McGuire, Barry Bonds before they came in the league, man. You know,
yeah,
Felix Hernandez was watching.
How do we know they're clean, though?
We don't. You don't know anything about anyone's clean. I would assume
we know
the way the MLB... I would assume they're clean.
Let's say that Barry Bonds should have been at, from 2000 to 2004, he should have been at, what do you think, about 35 home runs?
In the earlier part, like 2000, 2001, you could probably make a case that he's going more, even closer to 40, but at some point he would have tailed off. I mean, he played till he's 44, so you're talking 37, 38. You would think
42.
The bat speed would have declined even a little bit more. I would say like 28, 30, closer even than that.
Oh, you're talking 2005 through 2007 after he turned 40. I'm talking 35,
39, wouldn't he have slowed down a little bit?
Okay, let's say 28. All right, so let's, instead of just throwing out everything he did, let's go like this. Okay. Hold on 1 second, I got the calculator out. So he was averaging 51.6 home runs per year at that stretch. So let's say it drops down, because you had given him 40 for maybe the first couple of years. Let's just say 33. Okay, would be his average. Okay, so let's go.
How many did he hit in the year, like the 2 years before that?
He was right at 40, 42, 40, 37, 34.
All right. Yeah.
So let's say, it added 18 home runs a year on average. So let's take the 18 times 5, because after that he really fell off. And then let's divide that. Okay, so then that's 90. Let's say he had 90 home runs that he didn't deserve. So 762. So let's say he finished his career with 672 home runs. With the type of versatility he had, is he or is he not still a better player than Hank Aaron? Now we've subtracted the steroids, because that's really what it helped, was his home runs.
But wait, what about the years where he's 40 to 44? I mean, his last season, he still had 28 home runs.
He played until he was 42.
I would have swore
it
more than
that. Yeah, with the 28 home runs, 2007, I don't think he was using right at that point. There was some heat on him.
But he was, what 42-year-old hits 28 home runs? He was still huge.
Well,
I mean, look at the way he's slimmed down since then. If you see him in court or walking into the court, he's halfway in between what he was and what he is now.
Okay, so he was tracked, what, another 20 home runs then? I mean,
all the home runs from like 98 on.
No, you can't track them all. You can't subtract them all. You can't do that to him. Because you can't say that he was only hitting home runs because of steroids.
Yeah, but you can't tell which ones are from steroids, which is why he's not a Hall of Famer.
You can take a logical conclusion and say that it wouldn't have been as many. And then you've got to kind of come up with a way to quantify how much it helps. And you can do that from a logical standpoint. So subtract, because that's one thing, Tim, that I'm not down with, is just erasing everything. You know, like Pete Rose. Well, let's erase everything the guy did. Arguably the greatest contact hitter of all time. You know, let's erase everything he did because the guy freaking gambled.
Yeah, but gambling isn't making you a better player, though. It might even make you a worse player.
No, I know. That's even more ridiculous.
Yeah, that he should be in the Hall of Fame. He should be allowed back in baseball, but he should be in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I agree with that. Pete Rose, man, I mean, yeah, one of the best, like, you know, batting averages ever, you know, got on base the whole time, and this, you know, just because he gambled on the game. I mean, I could see him getting kicked out of baseball, but, like, hit what he did in the game. I mean, is Hall of Fame worthy? You can't.
Joe Jackson and anyone else who got kicked out for gambling that deserved to be there.
Yeah.
All right. Let me bring Bryce into this, and then we're going to go back through the guys here. Bryce. I don't know, I'm not hearing him. Maybe he's on to just listen. So back to Justin. Justin, do you think that we should just erase everything Barry Bonds has done? Or do you think we should try to find a way to kind of, you know, quantify how much it did help him?
I think it shouldn't be erased.
Based on what? So, from what year to what year? I mean, you just blanketly erase it?
I said I shouldn't erase it.
Oh, shouldn't be erased. Okay. So you think that we should try to come up with a way to quantify how much it did help him, and then try to factor that in?
Yeah. But isn't that like saying when someone gets caught cheating on a test, well, normally you get a 90 on the test, so let's try and quantify what you would have gotten if you weren't using your notebook to cheat on the test.
Okay. All right, that's fair enough. That's a good point. I'll give credit where credit's due. That's a good point.
Yeah, but it's a good point, but you got to put things in perspective. I mean, that's not the same magnitude as playing in a league where you're making millions and millions of money and eyes on you, you're hitting the ball. I mean, it's hard. You know, it's a different, to me, it's more of a different complexion, even though I see where you're going at. You know, I mean, plus, really, they don't really keep track of your tests like they do keeping track of your stats on the football, on the whatever ball team or whatever. You know, you're doing. I think it's just.
I don't know, Tim. I think that, in my opinion, as a 5-tool player, Barry Bonds was better than Hank Aaron. As a slugger, I think Hank Aaron blows, you know, Barry Bonds away. Because Barry Bonds only achieved what he did as a power hitter.
There were still years where he hit 40 off of steroids. Like, that's the thing. I mean, I just, that whole era, and maybe it's just because I was growing up during that time and I looked up to these type of guys, but seeing them do that and then finding out how they did it and it wasn't natural, I can't accept that, I guess.
Okay, I got a question for you, Tim. Okay, we look so much at the hitters. Think about the pitchers that were on it. So
you just have to go off what you know, though.
I mean, cause
Roger
Clemens
was on it, so he shouldn't be a Hall of Famer.
But think of this, though. Those guys weren't the only ones on them. You know? Those guys weren't the only hitters or pitchers on them. So you have to at least, you know, if they were on the level playing field with each other, because they were taking something to enhance their ability.
They weren't on a level playing field. The hitters were much, there are more use than hitters, and that's why it's come out. There's been way more hitters that have come out about steroids than pitchers. The one huge pitcher that's come out to Andy Pettit and Roger Clemens.
Well,
we don't hear about Pedro Martinez or Randy Johnson or any of those guys, because I don't think they did it.
Yeah, but think of this though, man. If you're throwing heat and you throw it to a sweet spot of the zone, you're going to end up hitting that ball, I mean, right out of there. I mean, that could happen. That's also possible for that to happen. I mean, I just don't see how it's just Barry Bonds, Mark McGwire, Sammy Sosa, and they're just going to throw those guys in the bus.
But that's what they know. They shouldn't be rewarded for cheating because other people cheated in the same era. They shouldn't.
I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. It should all be equal, though. because, I mean, they're not...
How about someone in the chat room brings up a good point. What about Barry Bonds' 8 Golden Gloves from 90 to 98? Didn't steroids hinder his all-around abilities and just turn him into more of a power hitter? I think no, it actually turns him into a lead versus power play. Yeah, it is. So let's put a fat asterisk next to his home run totals, but let's not take away what the guy was.
That's not fair to the people who got in the Hall of Fame clean. That's not fair to the people in the era who did it clean. Like, let's use
What about pitchers who were like Gaylord Perry, who's famous for the spitball? What about guys who had sandpaper
the glue
under their hat?
Yeah.
The world wasn't like that then, though. They didn't have media documenting everything, and if they played now, they wouldn't be allowed, but... Someone else cheating shouldn't give another person a reason to say, well, you cheated, so it's okay that I cheated.
Well, no. My point is, I wouldn't ask for Gaylord Perry to be banned from the Hall of Fame because he was a spitball pitcher. And I think Barry Bonds should be, and I'm not trying to give you a heart attack, Tim. I know it's All-Star night, but, you know, it's a fun debate because there's no right or wrong answer to this one. But I just think that Barry Bonds was an incredible player who made the mistake of trying to bulk up so he could be a home run hitter because he saw the admiration that, you know, Sammy Sosa and Mark McGwire received, and it was actually at the detriment to his ability to steal bases, his ability to be a great fielder.
Okay. Are you saying that he took anabolic steroids?
No, he did not. He tried anabolic steroids, and he had a bad reaction to it.
He ended up using cream.
It made his private area really small or something.
No.
Well, they can't find out about that.
That sounds like a funny internet rumor. But
yeah.
The cream in the clear is what Shane Mosley took to. And many other people.
Yeah, I know.
But...
Yeah, the cream is obvious, but...
Let's change the subject.